So the aluminum elbow is bolted to a pipe, and the bolts prevent the elbow from moving. We know things like the diameter of the entrance and the exit of the elbow. We know its mass, and we know the mass of the water inside of the elbow. We know the volumetric flow rate of water flowing through the elbow. We also know the inlet pressure is 30 kilopascal, which pushes the water through the elbow. It's exiting as a free jet, meaning the pressure here is atmospheric. And finally, I didn't specify it in the problem, but let's say that the flow rate is steady, which means that it's 15 liters per second for all points in time. It's not getting bigger, or it's not getting smaller over time. So in this flange is a series of six bolts that hold the elbow in place. Let's not calculate the forces acting on each individual bolt, but rather we're going to calculate the force of all of the bolts in total. So we're going to, from this side view, we'll say that this is the positive y direction. We'll call this FAY, the vertical component of force, and the horizontal component of all of the bolts, FAX. So what it means to answer this question, the X and the Y components of the force, it means that we're going to solve for FAX and FAY. To solve this problem, we're going to be working with our two momentum equations in the X and in the Y directions. Previously, we found the sum of forces in the X direction and the sum of forces in the Y direction. We brainstormed each of the forces in the X and in the Y direction. Before we do any of that, though, I want you to think about something. I want you to think about the Y component of the force of the bolts. So this force right here. I want you to think about, well, is it going to act upward? Are the bolts going to act upward on the elbow? Are they going to act downward? Or is it going to really depend on the flow rate of the water itself? Let's solve this problem. Previously, we expanded the sum of forces in the x direction. It was comprised of the anchoring force in the x direction plus the pressure at the inlet, P1, multiplied by A1. And A1 is equal to pi over 4 times T1 to the second power. It's just the area of the circle at the inlet. And there were only two pressures acting in the x direction. In the y direction, we had the anchoring force, the y component of the anchoring force, and we had the weight of the elbow and the weight of the water acting downward. And if we assume that this pressure is in gauge pressure, we don't have any atmospheric pressure pushing on the exterior of the nozzle. So the gauge pressure on the exterior of the nozzle is equal to zero. So these are all the forces in the x and in the y directions. So now let's examine the right-hand side of these equations. The first thing we're going to look at is the fact that we're assuming that the flow rate is steady, which means that it doesn't change over time. And what that means mathematically is the partial derivative of anything with respect to time is going to be equal to zero. On this first term on the right-hand side, we're taking the partial derivative of these volume integrals with respect to time. And because they're steady, both of these terms are equal to zero, and we can cross them out. So now let's examine the second term on the right-hand side of these equations. One thing I like to think about is V dot N, the dot product at the surface of our control volume. Let's draw the control volume. It includes the elbow and everything within it. So it's the surface of the elbow that comprises our control volume, and the control volume cuts through the water where it enters and where it leaves the elbow. So V dot N, let's take a look at it in this location. We'll draw unit normals everywhere, and we'll look at V dot N right here. Well, the velocity and the unit normal are orthogonal at that location. In other words, the water clearly is not flowing through the aluminum itself. And at that location, it will have the dot product is involves the cosine of the angle between the two. We'll have a cosine of 90 degrees, which is equal to zero. So V dot N at that location is equal to zero. In fact, it's equal to zero everywhere except at the entrance and at the exit. And we'll label those. We'll label the entrance is location 1 and the exit as location 2. And what that means then is we can take this integral, this surface integral, over our control volume, and instead of doing it over the entire control volume, the only place that it's not 0 is at location 1, so we'll say U1 row V1 dot N1, and at the exit, so location 2. So we'll say U2 row V2 dot N2. And here I've typed it out for the equations in the x and in the y direction. So So where we go from here is if we can figure out values for these integrals, we know the values of the other forces. We have numbers for those, and that's going to allow us to solve for fax and fay. However, to evaluate that, we're going to need to know numbers for u1 and v1 and u2 and v2. Well, to do that, let's start with a mass balance through the elbow. So the mass flow rate at 1 has to equal the mass flow rate at 2. And if we expand that, this is rho 1 times the magnitude of v1 multiplied by a1 is going to be equal to rho 2 times v2 multiplied by a2. Because we're dealing with water, rho 1 and rho 2 are equivalent. Water is essentially incompressible. And this allows us to solve now for the velocities at both locations. In fact, this is equal to the volumetric flow rate, Q, of 15 liters per second. A1 and A2 are just areas of circles, so it's pi over 4 times the diameter 1 squared and diameter 2 squared would come up with numeric values in units of square meters for both A1 and A2. And at this point, we do a bit of algebra and we can solve for V1 and V2, which is equal to the volumetric flow rate divided by A1 and the volumetric flow rate divided by A2. And we're left with 1.91 meters per second for V1 and 7.64 meters per second for V2. Note that I was real careful to convert from liters to cubic meters. There's 1,000 liters in every cubic meter. So now that we know values for V1 and V2, let's assess the dot product V1.N1 and V2.N2. V1.N1, which is equal to the magnitude of V1 multiplied by the magnitude of the unit normal, which is equal to 1, multiplied by the cosine of 180 degrees, which is equal to negative 1. So we're left with negative times the magnitude of V1, which we know is 1.91 meters per second. And by the same logic, we find that V2.N2 is equal to the magnitude of the velocity. So here at location 2, N2 and V2 are acting in the same direction. And the angle between them is 0. Cosine of 0 is equal to 1. So now what we'll do is decompose V1 into its horizontal U1 times I hat plus its vertical component V1 multiplied by J hat. Well, V1 occurs at the inlet of the pipe and the velocity is only going to the right, so there is no vertical component to the inlet velocity. V1 is equal to 0. So we can eliminate that term in our momentum equation. And this means then that U1 is just equal to the magnitude of V1. All of the velocity is in the horizontal direction. Similarly, we'll decompose V2 into its horizontal and vertical components. We know the angle of the elbow comes out at 30 degrees from the vertical. So with a little bit of trigonometry, we'll find that U2 is equal to the magnitude of V2 multiplied by the sine of 30 degrees. Similarly, V2 is equal to the magnitude of V2 multiplied by the cosine of 30 degrees, and here I'm including the negative sign because the exit velocity is in the negative y direction. So from here we'll make the following substitutions for u1 and v1 and u2 and v2 along with the dot products v1.n1 and v2.n2. And because these terms are uniform over the entrance and the exit, we can pull these out of the area integral. And when we evaluate the integral itself, we'll be left with something like the area of 1 dA, which is just equal to A1. And we'll do something similar for area. So here I've made the substitutions and simplified the x and the y momentum equations. So now we know everything. We're in a position to solve for fax and fay. And when we make all these substitutions, we solve for fax, we'll find that it's equal to negative 207 newtons, and fay is equal to negative 46 newtons. So the anchoring force, the bolts, the net amount of force, is acting downward and to the left. It's interesting to me that the anchoring force actually acts in the downward direction. I would have thought it acted in the upward direction because the bolts have to support the weight of the elbow. I mean, it's a little bit more intuitive to me that the bolts will act to the left in the negative x direction, and that's to fight the pressure which is pushing the elbow to the right. So if we came back to our original question about the Y component of the anchoring force, what we found was that the anchoring force had to act in the downward direction. But let's explore that a little bit more. To do that, I've made this graph of the Y component of the anchoring force as a function of the volumetric flow rate. So this is a volumetric flow rate of zero, as if we had put a cork in the end of our elbow. And over here is a volumetric flow rate of 0.015 cubic meters per second. And that's equivalent to what we're working with of 15 liters per second. So the value right here represents this negative 46 newtons that occurs at 15 liters per second. What's interesting to me though is if we back off the flow rate, if we slow it down from the original value, we find that the anchoring force begins to get smaller and smaller, and in fact it actually approaches zero at some point. And if we continue decreasing the volumetric flow rate, the anchoring force will be exactly equal to the weight of the water and the weight of the elbow. So it depends. It depends on the volumetric flow rate of the water. It's interesting that there is a volumetric flow rate that results in an anchoring force of zero in the vertical direction. And it's at this location that the nozzle is precisely supporting itself. So the elbow is acting a bit like a rocket. At really high volumetric flow rates, the nozzle has a tendency to want to take off, if you will, or fly upward. And the anchoring force from those bolts is holding the nozzle downward. Conversely, when the volumetric flow rate is zero, the anchoring force acts upward, and all it does is support the weight of the elbow and the water within it.